The Lion King expected nothing less than total respect. All the animals of the savannah should respect the Lion King. If the elephant or the rhino see him crouching in the bush, they do not forget to run past, bowing their heads in respect. The zebra and the giraffes respect him. Even the hippo stays away out of respect when he goes to drink at the bottom. Respect is great. Respect is important. So the Lion King was very angry when a silly little creature decided to show him very little respect.
One day the lion lay asleep in the forest. All of a sudden he heard a buzzing sound.
A mosquito buzzed around his ears and stung him on the nose.
The Lion King snapped at the horrid little traitor and bit his tongue.
Then in an attempt to chase Mosquito away, he struck at him with his mighty paw with such a blow that would fell like a gazelle.
But the mosquito slipped through his claws and laughed at the Lion King, showing no respect.
"Oh, great Lion King," said the mosquito, "bow your head before me in respect. I, the mosquito, have defeated you in battle."
The Lion King roared an almighty roar that sent the buffalo and the giraffe galloping across the savannah plains with the utmost respect.
Laughing, the mosquito flew backward into a gigantic spider web. The spider, showing respect to his king, swallowed the wretched insect in one gulp.
Somewhere later, the Lion King lay asleep again in the forest. A timid little mouse came up on him unexpectedly, and in her fright and haste to get away, he ran across the lion's nose.
Roused from his nap, the Lion King laid his huge paw angrily on the tiny creature to kill her.
"Spare me," called the poor mouse.
"Please let me go. Someday I will surely repay you." The lion was amused that a mouse could ever help him, but he was generous, and as the mouse had shown much respect, he let her go.
Some days later, while stalking his prey in the forest, the lion was caught in a hunter's net. Unable to free himself, he filled the forest with his angry roaring. The more his limbs struggled, the more he became entangled.
A hyena came by and saw the Lion King in his sorry trap. He cackled with his ugly voice and said disrespectfully, "In the morning, the men shall come and throw their spears into your side. Then we shall have to find a new king." Towards morning, the Lion King had almost given up hope when he heard a little voice. "My king," it said, "at last I may be of service to you."
"Last one I said I would prepare you," said the mouse. Into one of those great ropes that bound him, she gnawed until it parted, and soon the lion was free. Now you see that even a mouse can help a lion.
And so that is the story of how the king of the jungle came to respect those who respected him, no matter how small they were.